Cahill Brua Barracks. Cahill Brua Barracks used to be known as Portobello Barracks, as it was built in a part of Rathmines called Portobello. The building of Portobello Barracks began in 1810 and was finished in 1815. The barracks was designed as a cavalry barracks, which means it was designed for small army units which would use horses or some form of transport. More land was purchased and a church was added in 1842 and a canteen in 1868. In 1888, the cavalry left for McKee Barracks in Cabra. As you can imagine, there were many incidents at the barracks. Here are some interesting facts. In 1817, William Wyndham Sadler made a successful flight in a hot air balloon from the barracks ground to Holyhead in Wales. On the 17th of March 1916, the Countess of Limerick gave shamrock to the troops in Portobello Barracks. During the 1916 Rising and the Irish War of Independence, British troops from the barracks were involved in actions around Dublin. The worst of these was when three people were shot without trial in the barracks guardroom. They were Mr. Dickinson, Mr. McIntyre, and Mr. Sheehy Skeffington. Captain Calthorpe, who ordered the shooting, was judged to be insane at his trial. He spent 18 months in Broadmoor Prison in England. On the 18th of May 1922, Irish troops took over Portobello Barracks. It became the National Army's headquarters under Michael Collins. Michael Collins was a famous Irish leader. The Barracks Hospital became Michael Collins' home. On the 12th of August 1922, he left the barracks for the last time to tour the south of Ireland. He was killed on August 22nd, 1922. On 9th of May 1952, Portobello Barracks had its name changed to Cahill Brua Barracks. It was called after Cahill Brua, who was a leader during the 1916 Rising and was Minister for Defence in the First Dáil. He lived nearby for a time. Cahill Brua Barracks is still a working barracks today. It now has a military archive about the defence forces in Ireland. An archive is a collection of records and information.